थैंक यू गाइस। आई होप आई एम ऑडिबल राइट बैक देयर। दैट यूज टू बी माई सीट इन माई क्लासरूम, दैट्स व्हाई आई एम आस्किंग। But they used to be, she used to be far away to listen to my cries. The fear, the pressure took a toll, and one day I ran away. I ran away from my home. I could not go for long when my inner conscience shook me up and told me, "Hey, you think it's a Bollywood movie or something? You'll become a hero?" No. I came back. I said, I am a fighter. I'm going to prove my worth. Discover my potential. I don't need anybody's support. I'll tell you what am I. And I made a goal that one day I'll go into an army. Only option in my life, only goal, to become an Indian Army officer. No options, no confusions. 1997, that day came. I got commissioned into Indian Army. I was thrilled. I achieved my aim. I actually brought those stars on my shoulder. But life always takes turn. 1999. We were on war with our neighbors. I was deployed with my platoon on line of control. Shelling, bombardment, killing, mayhem, it was a daily affair. Sometimes we used to go across the border, kill them, chop their heads off. Sometimes they used to come to our side and dare us. Till one day, when it was total silence. No firing at all. That was a little terrifying for me. I was thinking, there is some storm going to come after this lull. And that fateful day on 15th of July 1999, the firing started again. The first bomb crossed over my head, fell far away, and the second bomb immediately next to me. I could not get any chance. Bomb disintegrated and all the shrapnels came into my body. Some cut through my legs, some embedded still inside my body. And I was lying there as a pool of blood. Fountain of blood was coming out of me and I fell unconscious within fraction of second for again silence. This time the silence was within me. Later on I came to know that it took me 2.5 hours to reach hospital, and when I reached there, doctor told he's dead, take him to mortuary. But I was lucky. There was another super specialist there available on the visiting. He was a visiting doctor that day and he revived me back. Third day, doctor comes to me and tells me, your leg is infected with gangrene. He took me to OT, he did something there, banded me, and he told me we need to further evacuate you further for better medical facilities. When I reached Udhampur, the bigger hospital in the Northern Command, doctor opened my bandage and I saw there's nothing left. A bone and a small amount of flesh. It was as if, you know, somebody has cooked a bad chicken curry and chicken leg has been eaten a bit and then thrown away. I knew that it is not going to survive, but doctor was still mustering courage to share that news with me. After some time, he comes to me and says, son, I think we need to impute it. There's nothing left. I said, sir, please go ahead, I can see. There's nothing left actually. That is where, again, I don't know how, but that positive thought struck me. And I thought, this is a new challenge. Let me now see how physically challenged people live. It's a new challenge for me. Destiny has actually played a game with me. But the last control was in my hand. It was my choice whether I want to lie down on the bed or whether I have to fight back and prove my mettle again, discover my new potential again. and I chose the second thing. That was a second birth. So of course, after birth, you know, you need to crawl, stand, walk. I cut short it a bit. I learned how to stand. I learned how to walk. I learned how to move with the crutches. And one day, I again took control of me. When Indian Army gave me another chance to go back to Kargil, this time not to fight there, this time for a peace. I did a car rally from Kargil to Kanyakumari in 19 days to commemorate the martyrdom, those soldiers who laid their life for our country. That was the peace mission. I was again happy that I have conquered the challenges, and you know, all physical injuries what occurred to me, perhaps I can take control of that. That's where God pats me back and says, hey, you think it's a joke going on? You think I have sent you on this world for a joke or something, a party? There's a lot to come. There are a lot of tests which still left to make me a better person. This time, the tests were not physical. They were emotional. And mind you, the emotional tests are even worse. That child who used to be devoid of love, affection, used to dream about one day when he will have his own family, his wife, his kids, and perhaps that care and things would come from his wife. It didn't happen like that. 2 visits to psychiatric ward, and we realized that it's not working out. We chose to part away mutually. She went abroad and I chose my motherland and my son. And you know what? What carries me on? My smile. Now I have to take care of physical and emotional injuries. I have to revive back again. I had my smile with me, but I have to learn more. So I chose to play, you know, games, sports are one thing where you get the motivation back. I learned how to play golf, then gradually shifted to squash. But still that adrenaline pumping rush was not there. Something was missing somewhere. So I chose, let's go back to rally. I was still not able to discover how to run, you know, that sweating out if I'm running, still missing. Because I have already done one rally, so I chose to go back to running. Red Day Himalaya was my dream, and it's still a dream. But it's a very costly affair, you know, lakhs of money, lakhs of rupees are required to. So I went to sponsors. And whenever I used to go to sponsor, they used to see my injuries. Oh my God, this guy, not worth of anything. They used to frown upon me. Yes, one thing I am worth of, you know, with so many injuries, we can play a game. You name a part, I'll tell you what injury is there. But then, every rejection became a catalyst for me. They rejected me. That's when I saw that ad, Airtel Delhi Half Marathon 2009. 21 kilometers, 40 days away. A tough task, but then again, no options, no confusion. Only aim to clear of this. That's all. How to do it, I don't know. I'll do it. I had to relearn the endurance which I lost 10 years back. I had to regain the stamina. And the most important part, I still didn't know how to run with my artificial leg. But then, what is a life without challenges? I took that challenge again. I was on road donning my jogging shoot, and gradually somehow I picked up how to learn with that artificial leg. Like this. See, of course, I have to just finish off 21 kilometers, not by walking. So I thought, let's do hopping. And the day came, and in 2009, with this leg, this leg is meant for walking, not for running, I finished my first half marathon. Oh my God, what an experience. 3 hours, 40 minutes, hell lot of a time. But I had to do it. Lot of pain, lot of thirst. And I remember when I crossed over the other side of finishing line, what an elation it was. I was actually tired after 10 years. I was actually hungry after 10 years. And I still remember that refreshment of apple which I got. I ate the inside core of that apple also with seeds. We generally throw away. You know, in childhood we used to say, if you eat this, there will be a tree grow inside you. I don't know where is that tree still. And in 2011, I became India's first blade runner. Now I could run actually, like this, the difference. But this is not the end. I discovered myself, I discovered my potential. There are a lot of people like me in India who still feel they are challenged. So I framed this, the challenging ones. I say, I am not challenged. I am the challenger. I can give you challenge. And that's how 12 men in 2011 Airtel Delhi half marathon, they participated in 6 km event. And you keep watching, this year in half marathon there would be some out of them running 21 kilometers with me. And you know what? What gives me that motivation, that pump? It's this. Whenever I see my flag, the adrenaline, the josh, it automatically comes. I discovered myself. You discover yourself, because India is nothing but you. If you discover your potential, you will discover a different India. I discovered myself. These men are discovering themselves. I might be devoid of my motherly love, but my mother earth, it always gives me that love. And I am going to keep fighting. Till that day when I sleep in the lap of this mother.